What is going on, guys? So today I'm hitting you with a video I don't think anyone expected, not even me. I'm gonna be honest, I did not think this was gonna happen. It wasn't last minute, but I've been looking to buy something for a while, and this one popped up and I thought it was a good deal, especially, you know, everything that was done to it. Oh, I'm gonna show you. This was kind of me being impulsive and kind of wanted to do something different in my life, and also not knowing what I want to do in my life. So I'm 24, midlife crisis. I'm just kidding. Maybe, I don't know. But yeah, I'm not going to do, you know, a crazy edit or like a crazy, you know, intro. Let me do a quick walk around. See what you guys think.
Buy a new car for the bitch.
For real.
I tear down the mall with the bitch.
For real.
You can't even talk to the bitch.
Nah.
She fucking with bosses and shit.
Oh God.
I pull up in Rarys and shit.
Sure.
With choppers and Harleys and shit.
For real.
I be Gucci down.
Gucci.
You wearing Lacoste and shit.
Bitch.
Yeah.
Montclair.
Yeah.
Furka and Mafia Bell.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Triple homicide. Put me in a chair. Yeah.
In jail.
Trip across the plug. We do not play fair. Yeah.
Oh God.
Got them tennis chains on and they real blingy
bling.
Draco make you do the chicken head like chingy
ching.
Walking Neiman Marcus and I spend a life 50-50. Please proceed with caution, shooters, they be right with me.
21
bad bitch, cute face, and some nice titties. 7500 on a Saint Laurent jacket,
yeah.
Bitch, be careful when you dumping yo action,
bitch.
I ain't no sucker, I ain't cuffing no action.
Nah.
The streets raise me,
wow.
I'm a whole
bastard.
I bought a Rari just so I can go faster.
Sure.
Niggas trying to copy me, they plan catch up.
21.
I might pull up in a ghost, no Casper.
21.
I been smoking gas and I got no
ass.
I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 M's in my bank account.
Oh yeah.
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 In my bank account.
Oh
I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 shooters.
Now that you guys saw it a little bit more, this is a 2011 ZR1. It has 55,000 miles. It has long tube headers, a full Corsa exhaust. It sounds mean. What's done to it is, you know, the exhaust, intake. They said the heads are done and has a cam in it. For how much power that's good for, I have no idea. But it sounds really cool. You know, I haven't ridden a stock one, so I don't know how fast that one is, or I have no idea how much they make stock. So, but yeah, this is me taking it on a canyon run, on some winding roads up to the lake, and see what you guys think about it. Peace. Okay, guys, so we're here on the GoPro. We're going for a spirited drive. Hopefully, I don't have my good mic on. Hopefully, you guys can hear me well. But we're going for a spirited drive in the new, brand new to me, 2011 Corvette ZR1. Let me turn on the AC. It's getting a little hot in Arizona. You know, it's like almost 70. It's 73 degrees outside. Are you kidding me? It's almost freaking boiling, dude. All right, let me point the air towards me a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna take this time to kind of tell you guys a little bit more about the car. So I bought this at a dealership in Phoenix here in Arizona. I saw it on their Instagram. They posted it up and they took it down, and you know, I thought they sold it. And then me buying this car, it was a long process. So I was like, by the end of everything, they were gonna sell it, you know. But nope. God was on our side and said, no, you need this Corvette. You need this Corvette for some reason. We're gonna find out why, right? So it is very tastefully modded. It is wrapped, hold on, quick. I don't know if you guys can hear the pops, but they sound good. every shift is a couple crackles, a couple pops. That's pretty sick. You know, it has some really sick forged line wheels. It is wrapped in AAA R's from Toyo. You know, these are the stickiest street tires you can probably get that aren't, you know, street legal, you know, radial tires. So the motor, I saw that the previous owner, he had a Kong 2650 blower on it from his, I kind of stalked his Instagram a little bit, but from what I saw, he had that blower on there. And from what they posted on the car, it is heads, cam, and intake only, I think. But I need to ask the original owner before he sold it to that dealership, see what the mods really are. So that is the motor. I have no idea what it's making. The dealership didn't know. So again, I have to ask the guy, see how much it's really making. Because, you know, if it has heads and cam, unless it was done really badly, or the specs of the cam and of the heads do not really match, you know, each other, it's really not going to pick up a lot of power. I can tell it's not a big cam, it's a smaller cam. It chops at light whenever that's out of stock, but it doesn't do anything crazy, you know. The interior is really nice too. You can tell it's very taken care of. The other owner took off that hideous OEM wheel. He put a carbon fiber wheel on there, which is really nice. I will say is that this car needs an alignment, because as you can tell, I don't know how well you can tell, I let off and it's pulling to the right. And the steering wheel is slanted to the left. So whoever put the steering wheel on either didn't notice till he put it on and he started driving it that it's crooked, or they noticed and they just didn't care to fix it. But I'm gonna take it to an alignment shop because these tires are expensive and I don't want them to be worn out that quickly. Ooh, those cracks. Other thing. Dude, I love this short. I don't know what company this is or who put it in, but I love this shifter knob and the short throw shifter. It is so crisp, so clean. Say I have missed a couple shifts already just because it's so tight and it feels so good. I'm so glad he upgraded, the previous owner upgraded this, because if you look at the original OEM shifter, it looks like a, I don't even know what it looks like. It looks like an old man's nub or something. And it looks all wonky. It's like tilted to the side. I'm gonna put it in sport right now. See if that does anything. Cause we are going to these curvy roads up here. And it's not gonna be nothing crazy. It's the middle of the day. As you can see, there's, you know, families and motorcycles going through here. So there's not gonna be any crazy driving right now. It's more of a spiritual awakening of the car. It's a little introduction for me and the car. We're gonna be like this, me and the car. We're gonna get to know each other. We're not here yet, right? We're gonna be like, we might be with one finger and then, you know, we might be over here and then slowly we're gonna be like this, you know? And then hopefully we're gonna be over here. Getting into the turns now. Still on, thank God. Okay, we're in fourth gear right now, and I'm gonna tell you again, this shifter is so crisp and sexy. It makes me want to do things to it. It makes me want to sit on it. I'm gonna tell you right now, it makes me want to sit on it. So it's so freaking crisp and sexy, dude. It's so good. The shifts are on point. Me with the shifts, that's a different story. You know, it's not really on point, but you know, I'm there, kind of. This is kind of the beginning part, so I'm gonna put the windows down. I'm gonna shut up so you can hear the car, hear me giggling, and yeah, let's get into the drive. She is in sport, so she should put it first. That is first, right? See, these gears are so close and tight. I'm like, is that first? Is that third or fourth? Second, reverse? I don't know. Oh, but it sounds so good.
It sounds so good. Oh, hold on, I'll shut up. Quick down shift. It does have carbon ceramic brakes, which I could feel even driving in traffic. They stop perfectly. And I can feel it even more. I'm not even really pressing the brakes. I'm kind of, I'm engine braking right now, but these brakes are amazing. They're top tier. They really are. Actually, if you go back and watch my channel for a little bit, if you watch the video where the guy crashed my bike, this is the exact road where he came and crashed it, which is kind of crazy. And he didn't tell me he was coming here. If I knew he was coming here, I would have been like, nope, you're not taking it. But he came here, and on one of these turns, he crashed. I don't know which one, but it was on this road to the lake. Oh man, that sounds so sexy, dude. Oh, I'm getting 70 miles to the gallon.